Hi, welcome to Learning Monkey. I am Raghu here. In this class, we will discuss about ReLU and switch activation functions. In our previous classes, we already discussed about sigmoid and tanh activation functions. For better understanding of this class, please watch our previous classes and come back here. The link for the playlist is provided in the description below. Coming to today's class, before going into the concept of ReLU and switch activation functions, in our last class, when we discussed about sigmoid and tanh activation function, what's the problem with tanh activation function? We are having a vanishing gradients problem. Why we got that vanishing gradients problem? Because the differentiation value, we are getting it almost near to zero, means 0.000 something like that. That is why we are getting a vanishing gradient problem. In order to overcome that, they started using the ReLU activation function. See, let's check the what is meant by ReLU activation function. ReLU is a rectified linear unit and the function given like this: f of x is equal to maximum of 0 comma x, means if x value is negative value, we are considering the maximum of 0 comma x, means consider 0 as the output. If x is positive value, our function is giving x as it is. The function looks like this. See, on the positive side, the x value is given as it is. On the negative side, if you are taking it as maximum of 0 comma x, if x is negative, maximum means a 0 value. This is how our ReLU activation function looks like. The derivative of this ReLU activation function is f dash of x is equal to 1 if x greater than or equal to 0. It is 0 if x less than 0. So here we are not getting any point, not something like that. We are getting the activation value as 1 or 0. So that's why we are not getting vanishing gradients problem here using ReLU activation function. But by using the ReLU activation function, sometimes you may get the problem of dead neurons. What's the dead neuron means? Suppose if you take the x value as 0, negative side, what's the value we are considering it as? 0. Means that neuron is not activated, it is dead neuron, and the differentiation of that neuron is 0. Means when we discuss about how to train the neural network, multi-layered neural network, we clearly discussed that if the differentiation value is 0, the weights are not updating, that's why we are getting dead neuron problem. In order to overcome this dead neuron problem, weights are not updating. Here 0 means the neuron is not activated, weights are not updating for this. So that's why in order to overcome that, we are using leaky ReLU. Leaky ReLU is just a slight modification of ReLU activation function. What they consider here is f of x is equal to 0.01x, means we are considering a small percentage value of x if x is negative value, x less than 0. Otherwise, we are taking it as x as it is, x greater than or equal to 0. That's why we are having the function looks like this. On the negative side, we are considering a 0.001x value. So the differentiation of this function is f dash of x is equal to 1 if x is positive, otherwise it is 0.01 if x less than 0. To avoid the problem of dead neurons, leaky ReLU is used. And next activation function is switch activation function. Recently, they have given this switch activation function. So Google has used this switch activation function on ImageNet dataset. So what is ImageNet dataset? All these discussions we will discuss in our when we discuss about convolution neural network. So in the research paper, they have given that. So on large data sets, when we are using large number of layers in our neural network, switch function is working better when compared to ReLU function. That is what they have given in the research paper. So they showed it on the ImageNet data set. So how this switch function works, what is this switch function? All these things will be discussed here. The switch function is given as f of x is equal to x into sigmoid of beta x. Beta is a constant here. We can take any constant value beta, but most of them, they will show it as sigmoid of x. They consider beta as 1. So let's check what happens if you change the beta value. Beta is a constant. If you take beta is equal to 0.01, means if we are taking very small value, it's almost near to 0, then our switch function is working almost linear. Forget about it is not drawn properly. It is almost working as a linearly. So why it is working linear? It's working as a linear function. Let's check that beta, let's take if beta is equal to 0. 0 into x, what is that 0? Sigmoid of 0 is 0.5. We discussed in machine learning in sigmoid function, sigmoid of 0 value is 0.5. 0.5 into x is a linear function. That's why when it is near to 0, beta value is very, very small. This function is working almost linearly. If you take beta is equal to 10, if you are taking beta as a big value, how this function is working? As it is working, this blue line, it is working exactly similar to ReLU function. If you take beta is equal to 1, this is how it is working. The values which we got is a green line. So that's why this swish function is a trade-off between linear and rectified linear unit, ReLU function. It's a trade-off between, you can take a value between and you can check different beta values also. So that's why, and the next one is the derivative of this f dash of x is the biggest problem with swish function is this is the derivative value is computationally costly. So you see, if f of x is a swish function, what's the derivative value of swish function? F dash of x is equal to f of x plus sigma of x into 1 minus f of x. This is what the derivative value is. The derivative, the functions of derivative values is given like this. See here, we discussed that if you are taking beta is equal to small value, it is working similar to linear function. That's why for beta is equal to 0, the value we got here is like this. And if you take beta is equal to 10, it is working as if you take large beta values, it is working as a ReLU activation function. What is the derivative value for ReLU activation function? If it is positive, it is 1, otherwise it is 0. See here, the blue line is exactly similar to, not exactly, but almost all near to, it is going up and it is, from here it is taking 1 value. See, from here it is taking 0 value, it is working as ReLU activation function. And the trade-off between these two is, it is working like this, this green line. This is all about swish activation function. Hope you understand the concepts of ReLU and swish activation functions. If you have any questions regarding the concept, please post your questions in the comment section below. Thanks for watching. If you haven't subscribed to our channel, please subscribe to our channel and press bell icon for the latest updates. Please share if you feel that this video is very helpful for you, please share it with all your friends. Thank you.